Hi, my name is Tobias Siegel. The popularity of ozone continues to grow around the world, sparking new innovations and improvements in ozone production. In this video, I'm going to go over how ozone is created, why ceramic ozone cells are the current frontrunner in quality and safety, and why continued innovation is going to only make ozone better than ever. First, what is ozone and how is it created? Ozone is also known as O3 and is created by combining three oxygen atoms. This is why it is often referred to as activated oxygen. The most popular methods for creating ozone are corona discharge, cold plasma, ultraviolet light, and electrolysis. We'll focus on the most popular, corona discharge. Corona discharge is also called cold corona. It requires running pressurized high purity oxygen into an ozone cell where oxygen contacts an electric field, forming ozone. Our ozone generators use this method with a ceramic electrode in the cell. In the O3 Elite, the cell is a long cylindrical tube with a narrow ceramic electrode extending down the center. In the O3 Arc, the cell is similar but has been unrolled to maximize the ozone efficiency and cooling properties. These electrodes act as inert dielectric barriers, allowing the oxygen to react inside the electric field. The ceramic material in these ozone cells is made from an aluminum oxide ceramic, known in some industries as alumina ceramic or sapphire ceramic. This is not the metallic form of aluminum. That's a very important distinction. Aluminum oxide is used in a wide variety of applications and, like glass, can be formed into all kinds of shapes depending on how it will be used. It is considered a high-quality, biocompatible ceramic, meaning it is safe to use. It is naturally formed on the outer layer of any aluminum surface that is exposed to oxygen, which happens in a matter of nanoseconds. The three parts of oxygen at the end of Al2O3 indicates the compound is in its highest state of oxidation and can't be oxidized further. It simply won't break down as it encounters more oxygen. This is why it is an ideal material to use in an ozone production cell. It is one of the most inert, naturally occurring compounds and has a durability second only to diamonds. This is why most airplanes and jets are constructed of aluminum oxide metal alloys. It not only keeps the planes lighter, it also ensures they won't easily fall apart due to the weathering effects of oxidation that compromises the integrity and durability of other metals. A cell made with these materials has a very long lifespan, which is why our ozone cells have a lifetime warranty. In case you have any other concerns about aluminum oxide ceramic, consider how it is used in medicine. It is utilized in many implants and medical devices because it is safe and inert in the body while being durable enough to hold up over time. In modern dentistry, most dentists have replaced the use of toxic amalgam fillings with alumina and other durable ceramics. Aluminum oxide is the most common option now for dental implants. We didn't want to settle for that. We wanted to prove our ceramic ozone cells are safe, so we tested the purity of the ozone produced by the O3 Elite and O3 Arc ozone generators to confirm there are no contaminants created as a byproduct during ozone production. The tests included testing for all major heavy metals and aluminum. The result was 100% contaminant-free ozone. We can claim our ozone generators are safe because we proved it. Another important consideration with ozone is heat. Ozone is very unstable at higher temperatures. So if your machine creates too much heat, your ozone output will not be as strong or as stable. Our ceramic cells have two key features that solve this problem. Excellent dielectric properties require lower voltage, which creates much less heat. High voltage generators naturally heat up and often require noisy fans. The thermal conductivity for aluminum oxide ceramic is about 30 times greater than quartz glass, which is another material commonly used in ozone cells. This means the natural heat dissipating qualities of aluminum oxide ceramic help the electrodes stay at lower temperatures consistently, making them much more efficient and stable in comparison to glass. Not only does this allow for cool production, lower voltage is safer for consumers and makes it easy to use worldwide without a step-down transformer. We include a plug kit with international orders so the unit can be plugged into a wide variety of outlets. You can also buy the plug kit from us if you plan to travel. Now that we've gone over how a ceramic ozone cell is inert, safe to use, creates no harmful byproducts, and solves the problem of heat, let's go over some other features of our ozone generators. One leading advantage with the O3 Elite and O3 Arc are adjustable ozone levels. These are not one-size-fits-all machines. Ozone units that only produce one amount of ozone will usually be too weak or too strong, never right where you want them to be. With the O3 Elite and O3 Arc, you can choose an ozone concentration level that matches your needs and adjust the output accordingly. All of the components in our ozone generators that come in contact with ozone gas are A-rated for ozone compatibility. This means it is perfectly safe for all ozone therapy applications. The O3 Elite and O3 Arc are made from parts and components sourced in the United States, and we assemble them in many other products by hand in our Fayetteville, Arkansas facility. Our strict policy on sourcing high-quality components combined with on-site assembly ensures a high level of quality control. This is why we can guarantee our generators operate as intended and why we offer a lifetime warranty on our ozone cells. If you want more information on the O3 Elite, the O3 Arc, or ozone in general, please visit our website linked in the description. Before I go though, I wanted to give some thoughts on innovation and what it could mean for the ozone industry. Let's start with an important point. Aluminum-based ceramics are currently widely used in the medical ozone generator market in Europe, where ozone generators are approved by an independent agency. Obviously, it is a great material, as we have covered, but there might even be better material choices that haven't been utilized yet. As with any industry, technology and research help us discover new materials which might be better suited for ultra-stable ozone production. Glass is also a good material to use for electro design and ozone production and has been in use for over 150 years when Wernher von Siemens developed the first industrial ozone generator back in 1857. This has been shown to be an effective material to utilize, but it also has some drawbacks which haven't been properly addressed. As we mentioned earlier, glass electrodes retain a lot of heat from the electric field due to the thermal conductivity of that material. As we know, heat speeds up ozone degradation, and this produces fluctuating and even unstable ozone output depending on the conditions. This is why innovating and finding better materials is necessary to continue creating better and better ozone. Think about it like this. Consider airplanes. The first generation of airplanes were made from super light materials like spruce wood and canvas to achieve flight in the early 1900s. These materials worked well for that first generation of aircraft and achieved the intended goal of flight, but over time, technology advanced and better materials were utilized, and thus the production of aircraft has improved significantly over the past 120 years. It's strange to think about it, but if aircraft manufacturers never innovated with better materials, we might still be flying short distances in wooden planes today. Some ozone machines today still use older materials that are not as efficient and produce more heat. A resistance to change is a resistance to improve, and improvements always progress as long as someone is willing to put in the effort. Why stay behind the curve? It might be easier, but it also means you will get left behind. Innovation is critical to any industry, and this helps drive the need for more research and analysis to develop even better products that benefit the consumer and the market as a whole. We understand and appreciate the fact that competition helps drive innovation and welcome this innovation process which improves these existing ideas and designs. Glass electrodes have been in use for over 150 years in ozone, and although they effectively accomplish the goal of ozone production, there are better materials available. Better materials like aluminum-based ceramics that can be utilized to improve upon the existing design and allow us to produce ozone in an inert environment that creates contaminant-free ozone, which is much more stable and allows for consistent ozone output. The winners of innovation are ozone therapy users who get better, safer ozone for a growing array of ozone applications. If you like this video, consider subscribing to our YouTube channel. Check out our website at www.promolife.com for more ozone therapy products and information.